Elliptic curves are fascinating. For example, Fermat's last theorem was solved by Andrew Wiles in 1995 using elliptic curve. The problem remained unsolved for over 300 years. The Fermat's last theorem says that for equation xn plus yn is equal to zn has no solution for n greater than 2. Secondly, Clay Institute of Mathematics has suggested 7 different mathematical problems. For solving each problem, Clay Institute of Mathematics offer $1 million reward. These problems include P versus NP, Riemann hypothesis, Yang-Miller mass gap problem, Poincaré conjecture, which is already solved by Russian mathematician, and one of these problems is Busch and Simmerton-Dyer conjecture. This problem deals with finding a real value solution of a higher degree polynomials, such as elliptic curves. So you can say that elliptic curves can help you to get Abel Prize, which is considered to be a Nobel Prize in mathematics, as Andrew Wiles was rewarded with Abel Prize. And similarly, elliptic curves can reward you $1 million if you is able to solve one of the problems offered by Clay Institute of Mathematics. But the most exciting part of elliptic curves is in cryptography. Because of many known attacks against RSA, we have to use a very large key size in order to attain reasonable security. Similarly, discrete logarithmic problem again over prime fields also has to use a very large key size because of general number field safe problem. However, this attack does not work on elliptic curve over finite fields. Therefore, in elliptic curves, we can use a very small key size. For example, a key size of 512 bits is enough to provide security equivalent to 256 bits of advanced encryption standard. So elliptic curves provide us security using a small key size. Therefore, in resource-constrained devices, where enough energy is not available, we cannot use RSA and discrete logarithmic problem over prime fields, but we can use elliptic curves. Similarly, elliptic curves are also faster because of the small key size as compared to other asymmetric algorithms. These are just 3 examples. In fact, learning about elliptic curves and curves of a higher degree and multiple variables will open new gateway of research and mathematical understanding. In the next lecture, I will introduce elliptic curves over finite field. So stay tuned.